Good evening, chillers. Today, biology class. Okay, today topic dialysis. Dialysis, it is also called as artificial kidney. Artificial kidney. Artificial kidney. Okay, last class I explained ESRD. ESRD. What is mean by ESRD? ESRD means end stage of renal disease. End stage of renal disease. End stage means two kidneys completely failed. Two kidneys completely failed. The disease name is called end stage of renal disease. Human being have a one pair of kidney, means two kidney. Two kidneys function completely failure. What is the main function of kidney? Removal of nitrogenous waste substance from our body. Removal of nitrogenous waste substance from our body. In some cases, especially diabetes means chakra bimari, some other health problems, edaina anarogyala karananga, or sometimes bacterial viral infection inside the kidney. Okay, sukshma jeevula karananga two kidneys completely failure means function failure. Kidneys are present as it is in our body. But what is the function? Removal of nitrogenous waste substance. Kidney la yokka panithayindi vadapoyadam. Okay, poorthiga rakthanni vadaposi rakthamlo unna malinalanu bayatiki pampinche paddhatini vadapotha paddhati anta. Ee kidney lo yokka mukhyamaina pani enti? Rakthanni vadaposi rakthamlo unna nitrogen ante నైట్రోజన్ సంబంధిత పదార్థాలను శరీరం నుంచి ఆ రక్తం నుంచి వేరు చేసే పద్ధతి. అవి ఏవి చేస్తాయి? కిడ్నీలు చేస్తాయి. అనివార్య కారణాల వల్ల మీన్స్ డయాబెటీస్ ఆర్ అదర్ హెల్త్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఆర్ మేబీ సమ్టైమ్స్ మైక్రో ఆర్గానిజమ్స్ కాజెస్ ఎఫెక్ట్ టు ద కిడ్నీ. టూ కిడ్నీ ఫంక్షన్ కంప్లీట్లీ ఫెయిల్. రెండు కిడ్నీల యొక్క రెండు మూత్రపిండాల యొక్క పని అనేది పూర్తిగా ఆగిపోతుంది. దట్ కండిషన్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యురేమియా. వాట్ ఈస్ యురేమియా? ఇన్ అవర్ బాడీ టూ కిడ్నీస్ ఫంక్షన్స్ కంప్లీట్లీ ఫెయిల్యూర్. దట్ కండిషన్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ యురేమియా. వన్ మార్ క్వశ్చన్ దే ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ ఇన్ బోర్డ్ ఎగ్జామ్, వాట్ ఈస్ యురేమియా? Two kidneys function completely failure. That condition is called uremia. Okay, what is the ESRD? End stage of renal disease. This disease, two kidneys are failure. Okay, children. So when two kidneys are function failure, filtration function is failure, then we are depending on other sources. That is called dialysis or artificial kidney. Okay, what is dialysis? It is what function they are doing the kidneys in our body, same function by the machine. That machine name is called dialysis machine. It is also called as an artificial kidney. అంటే మన శరీరంలో మూత్రపిండాలు ఎలాంటి పనిని చేస్తాయో, అంటే రక్తాన్ని వడగొసే ప్రక్రియ చేస్తాయో, అలాంటి ప్రక్రియను ఒక మిషన్ ద్వారా చేస్తుంది. దాన్నే డయాలసిస్ అంటారు ఇంగ్లీష్లో, తెలుగులో డయాలసిస్. ఓకే, that is called artificial kidney. If dialysis is not done, two kidneys are failure, in our body urea, water, nitrogenous waste substance level increased in the blood, so sometimes it causes poison, maybe person will die. Okay. If increase the water level, nitrogenous waste substance level increased in the blood, maybe legs or foot. Okay. Foot area, hives. Sorry. Swallowed. Swelling will occur. Okay, water level increased in the blood is good. It causes swelling. Okay. Now, we can learn today about dialysis machine, artificial kidney working. Okay, that working function we can learn today. This machine, dialysis machine, works like a kidney. Here, mainly like the systems are present, tubular systems. One tubular system. This is dialysis fluid. Dialysis fluid. This fluid act like a plasma. Act like a plasma. Same. How is it plasma composition? Same composition in dialysis fluid. In this fluid, same composition like dialysis fluid composition, like plasma composition. After the return collected here, this is also used dialysis fluid. Used one, after used we collect here. Okay. Dialysis fluid through this tubular system, it circulates. From patient, person. From person to large artery. Large artery to be collect. For example, this is a large artery to collect the blood. We can collect the blood. This is large artery. Large artery to be collect the blood. From patient, person to, we collect the blood from large artery. We collect the blood from large artery to we are sending. Here we are adding heparin. Heparin, it is helpful for coagulation, anticoagulant. Heparin, heparin send to persons. Here it is crossing.
Yeah, nitrogen substance enter into dialyzing fluid. Dialyzing fluid. Why? Because this is a high concentration. More amount of nitrogen is present. Nitrogen, nitrogenous waste substance is present. Nitrogenous. Nitrogenous waste substance. These waste substance by diffusion process enter into dialyzing fluid. Okay, like this. Total entered in dialyzing fluid by diffusion process enter into from blood to enter into dialyzing fluid. Nitrogenous waste enter into dialyzing fluid. Okay, you see here blood. It contains large amount of nitrogenous waste substance. It is circulating through this tubular system, circulate. Then afterwards, the total nitrogen waste enter into dialyzing fluid. Such dialyzing fluid also collected here in another bottle. Okay. After removing nitrogenous waste, that blood. Again, we can send into person's artery. Before sending, here we can add anticoagulant vitamin. Sorry, injection. Anticoagulant. First, we can inject anticoagulant substance before sending into the person heparin. Okay, this is the dialysis process. First, from person to we are collecting blood through large artery to send into dialysis machine. Before sending here, we add anticoagulant substance. Because of prevent the coagulation inside the machine. Okay, then here exchange of gases, exchange of waste substance. In here, exchange of waste substances from blood to nitrogenous waste substance enter into dialyzing fluid. Okay, then that after circulating in tubular system, then again this blood send into person's artery. Before sending artery, we can add heparin. Heparin prevent the clotting of blood inside the blood. Same dialysis fluid also through this tubular system circulate. They absorb the nitrogenous waste substance. After absorbing, they collect into another bottle. This process is called hemodialysis. 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 What is hemodialysis? From blood to we are separating the nitrogenous waste substance. It is called hemodialysis. Okay. Okay. Hemodialysis. What is hemodialysis? From blood to we are separating or cleaning the nitrogenous waste substance, cleaning the waste substance from the blood is called hemodialysis. This method first time discovered by the famous scientist Cuff, J. Cuff. Each dialysis, it will take time approximately 3 to 6 hours. 3 to 6 hours. Each dialysis process, it will take approximately 3 to 6 hours. Next topic, kidney transplantation.
किडनी ट्रांसप्लांटेशन, किडनी ट्रांसप्लांटेशन मीन्स ऑलरेडी आई सेड ईएसआरडी एंड स्टेज ऑफ रीनल डिसीज, एंड स्टेज ऑफ रीनल डिसीज ईएसआरडी इन दिस प्रोसेस और इन सम केसेस टू किडनीज फंक्शन इज फेल्यूर, टू किडनीज फंक्शन फेल्यूर, complete two kidney function is failure. At least we can save the person required one kidney. With one kidney we can survive. With one kidney person can survive. With one kidney person can survive. How we can do? We can remove the, we can transplant from healthy person to we collect the kidney, transplant to person who suffering with ESRD or dialysis. Okay, continue. We can not depending on dialysis. On dialysis, we can continue up to transplantation. Okay, transplantation mean important. Nearest blood relatives are required. Okay, transplantation or kidney donor, donor required nearest blood relative means better blood. Relatives, blood relatives means brother, sisters, anyone, blood relatives kidney easily match, easily we can transplant the kidney from donor to patient or recipient. Recipient means who receives the kidney, that is called a recipient. Donor means who donate the kidney, that person is called donor. Okay, two kidneys in failure, they cannot survive. Okay, there continue depending on dialysis how many days, but at least one kidney required, they want to survive. From where to we can collect? We can collect from the blood relative or close relative. Closely relative means mother, father, brother, sister, cousins, these all closely relatives. Okay, nowadays it is not available, we are depending on other sources. Suppose sometimes some accidents occurred. Okay, for example, brain dead cases, they donate the kidney. Brain dead cases are some injuries, some accident. Okay, from that person to we collect the kidney, we can transplant to the patient or recipient who required the kidney, that is the recipient. Okay, this kidney transplantation, first time in the world wise, they done. In the year 1954, Dr. Charles Fungal, okay, first blood transplant, sorry, kidney transplantation in 1954, Dr. Charles Fungal in Washington is a surgeon. In India also, first kidney transplantation in India, 1971, 1st December, December 1st. Where they done kidney transplantation? CMC Medical College, Christian Medical College. CMC means Christian Medical College, Veluru, Tamil Nadu. TM is Tamil Nadu. Okay, in first kidney transplantation in India, 1971, December 1st, hospital, Christian Medical College, Tamil Nadu. But doctor name not given in your book. The doctor name Dr. Venugopal, first kidney transplantation that done. Okay, next one. Other excretory organs. Okay, we can learn kidney transplantation, no doubt, no? Next, other excretory organs. Other excretory organs. In our body, kidneys are the first primary excretory organs. These are primary excretory organs. Some secondary excretory organs. Secondary excretory organs like skin,
lungs, intestine. Okay, these are secondary excretory organs. First, primary excretory organs are our kidney. Mainly, large amount of nitrogenous waste substance we remove by kidney. But some others, or some amount of waste substance we can remove by skin, lungs, intestine, and liver. Other excretory organs, you know very well skin. Total our body covered with skin. It is the largest organ. Skin contains small pores is called sweat pores. Okay, through skin we can remove the sweat. Okay, sweat. Sweat pore. Through the sweat pore we can remove the nitrogenous waste substance, and in the sometimes through the sweat pore we can remove the cholesterol also. Some cholesterol. Next one, lungs. You know very well, exchange of gases, removal of carbon dioxide. Okay, inhale of oxygen, removal of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide also excretory substance we remove through the respiration by lungs. Okay. Next one, intestine. Through intestine, some waste substance, especially ions. So many ions like calcium, potassium, magnesium, some other waste substance through the fecal matter. Fecal matter means stool or excreta. Through latrine, excreta nothing but stool. Through stool, we can remove the nitrogenous waste substance, ammonia, okay, and ions, some amount of water also we can remove by intestine. And last one, very very important one, liver. Liver is the important organ in our body. You know very well, RBC cells lifespan 120 days. What is the lifespan of RBC cells? 120 days. Okay, RBC means red blood corpuscles. What is the lifespan? 120 days. After 120 days, they can die. It goes to spleen. Spleen is also called as graveyard of RBC cells. RBC cells, Rakta Kanala Smashana Vatika. Objective lo adugutarama Telugu medium vallu. Rakta Kanala, Erra Rakta Kanala Smashana Vatika, spleen. Graveyard of RBC cells is called spleen. Okay, Erra Rakta Kanala Jeevita Kalamu, 120 Rojulu. Erra Rakta Kanala Smashana Vatika, spleen, Pihamu. Okay, RBC cells, after 120 days, it goes to spleen. Spleen to expand to liver. In liver, that RBC cells will rupture totally. It convert into bile juice. This bile juice help for destruction or dividing of fat substance or large fat globules divided into simple globular structures. Already I explained in digestive system. Okay, children. Once again, listen. Other excretory organs. Kidney are the primary excretory organ. Secondary excretory organs like skin, lungs, intestine, and liver. Skin is the largest organ total covered our body. Skin contains small pores, it called sweat pores. Through the sweat pores, we can send out the waste substance, especially nitrogenous waste substance, cholesterol, glycerol, oily substance we can send out the body. And body also cool. Okay, cooling system or thermal system. Second one, lungs. By respiration, we removal of carbon dioxide. Third one, intestine. Okay, large intestine, colon, ions, and nitrogenous waste substance like ammonia, some undigested food substance
we send out the body in the form of stool. Stool nothing but excreta or fecal metal or latrine. Visarjaka padarthalni manam visarjistam. Okay, last one, liver. Liver is the important excretory organ. Before liver, you can learn RBC, red blood corpuscles. What is the lifespan of RBC? 120 days. After 120 days, they goes to spleen. Spleen to, it goes to liver. Inside the liver, rupture the all RBC cells, convert into bile juice. This bile juice helps for in digestion of fats. Digestion not a correct meaning means, divide the fat globules into simple globular structures. Okay, large globules divided into simple globules with the help of bile juice. Okay, here, you can tell me. Ella rakta kanala yaka jeeta kalamu, nuta ibe rojulu. Nuta ibe rojulu tarvata, avi spleen, ante plihan kilti. E plihane, ella rakta kanala smashana vartika anta. English medium children. RBC cells lifespan 120 days. After it goes to spleen, spleen is also called as graveyard of RBC cells. Very, very important objective question. Okay, children, next. Other excretory organs. Okay, first one, lower organism, protozoans, the simple diffusion. For example, amoeba, simple diffusion. Excretion in other organisms. Here, by classification given, protozoans. Protozoans. Protozoans means, example, amoeba. Amoeba, it is a shapeless, okay, exchange after metabolic system, waste substance are formed inside their body. How they want to remove? By diffusion process. High concentration to low concentration, low concentration to high concentration. It is called simple diffusion. Simple diffusion. Simple diffusion means, here nitrogenous waste substance are formed, here nitrogenous waste substance are less. They send out the body. Okay, from high concentration to low concentration is called simple diffusion. Amoeba, protozoans. Next one, porifera. Porifera phyla, sponges. Sponges, they are fix into the rocks, they cannot move. There is small pores, small holes on body, on their body, small holes by exchange of water. Water, they are living in water, sea and fresh water, sponges are two types. Okay, water pass through their body. Okay, then waste substance also coming outside through the water. Okay, children, next one, that is called water bathing system. Water bathing system. Water bathing system is water pass through the pores. Okay, then waste substance also coming outside. This is called water bathing system. Next one, platyhelminthes, flail cells, nematyhelminthes, renty cells, annelida, nephridia, arthropoda, green glands, mollusca, metanephridia, echinodermata, water vascular system, reptiles, aves and mammals through the kidney. Okay, this table is very, very important. Compulsory you can read. Sometime they are asking in objective questions. Okay, children, today I completed excretion in animals. Next class we can learn excretion in plants. If any doubt, you can discuss or you chat in chat box. I can clarify your doubts. Okay, children. Thank you. Next class for yours, Telugu. Okay.